Hey, what's up YouTube? Jacob Love here, and today we are doing another answering your questions video, like I previously stated in my earlier video. So let's get started. First question is from my friend Tori Collins, and she asks me, what was the biggest thing that ever flew? I think I mentioned this in my last video. It was one of my favorite prehistoric predators, but as far as the biggest thing that ever flew, you have two animals to choose from. Excuse me, I just had dinner. So, you could either go with Quetzalcoatlus, which is an American pterosaur that ranged from, 35 to 40 feet in wingspan. And similar enough, there was Hatzegopteryx in Europe. So, as far as size is concerned, those two were pretty big. And if you want to put that into perspective by having an analogy and comparison, think World War II fighter plane. So these things were as big as a fighting airplane in World War II. Hope that answers your question. And to our next question is from Brandon Cook. And he asks me, what were the reasons for the small arms on the T-Rex? I'm glad you said reasons instead of reason. Because scientists and paleontologists and paleo enthusiasts like myself have long suspected what a T-Rex's arms would have been used for. And there are multiple different theories, and I think it's more of a combined theory that I'm about to state. It's where a T-Rex would use its arms not only to probably hold food or probably, you know, manipulate nesting materials, but where on the T-Rex do you think its arms are? Obviously, they're right at the front, right on the chest. One theory for T-Rex's arms is that the reason they still have them is for, you know, they use them as sexual claspers during intercourse for breeding. Much like how sharks have those, what is it called? I think pectoral fins? I don't think it's pectoral, but they have sexual claspers right around their cloaca. Now, a T-Rex doesn't have that, but he does have those two fingered hands on, despite for their small size, relatively strong arms. So, one theory is that they used them to hold food or manipulate nesting materials, whereas other theories are used them for, you know, sexual purposes. And I think I'm more a fan of the last one because that makes a lot of sense. Because if you're a T-Rex and you're only, I'd say, two-thirds smaller than your mate, the female's bigger than you, dude. You better have something to calm her down. And another theory is they used them to stroke the back to calm down the female. So you might want to do that with a woman who's way bigger than you. Our next question is from my friend Tori Collins again. And she asks me, did T-Rex mate for life? That's a very interesting question because when you look at predatory birds today, such as eagles or hawks, they often mate for life, or they have a preferred mate over others. I think T-Rex would have been similar. T-Rex would have probably had a preferred mate, but when a younger or a more dominant male appeared, he would get the breeding rights to her because, well, to her, that guy was more impressive than her previous mate. So it's kind of similar to how people are. Only difference is that once we slip on a ring, there's no going back unless, you know, cheating and being unfaithful is a thing for people. But as far as dinosaurs are concerned, if you want a partner, you've got to be the strongest and most fit to secure one. And of course, you need to make sure that, you know, you don't piss off your mate either, because she could eat you. So, to summarize, did T-Rex mate for life? I'm not really sure, but I do believe that they would have had preferred partners over other tyrannosaurs. Hope that answers your question, and on to our next one, which is from Sarah McKenzie Spears, or Sarah Spears, depending on who you ask. I always thought of her as Mackenzie. She asks me, which dinosaurs were the most dangerous? Well, for me, the most dangerous dinosaurs would be velociraptors and troodonts and, you know, the raptor dinosaurs, the dromaeosaurs. These things were very smart, very cunning, and they could figure out, they had problem-solving intelligence, as I'm sure most Jurassic Park fans know, but this is actual proven fact. Let's see what else. And this is only because in our time and age, where we live in houses and we live in, you know, cities and such, a velociraptor would be what a little bit more dangerous, considering that it's very fast, it's very sneaky, and it could probably figure out a way to either open our doors, go through the doggy door, back door, under the house, you name it. But out in the open, you definitely don't want to run into a T-Rex or any large carnivore. So I hope that answers your question, Mackenzie, and I hope you enjoyed this part of your video. Next up is Erin Elsie, who, as usual, gives a good question. And she asked me, could dinosaurs actually open doors? Which is a good follow-up to what I just said. And here's what I think. Yes, they could open doors if they, you know, figured it out, which takes a good bit of intelligence for any animal. If dogs and cats and in some cases birds, squirrels, you name it, can open a door, you can bet a dinosaur could. But you have to keep in mind one thing. Sometimes they don't have to. Because if a dinosaur is big enough, it'll just knock down the door. It doesn't take much sense to say, okay, I'm big, so I'll just knock it down. But if it was a smaller dinosaur, it would only have to be smart enough to figure, what if I just turn this knob or this latch and just go through it like those big two-legged things did? So, really, it's just common sense to do either one of two ways. If you're big, knock it down. If you're small, just figure it out. And if you're smart enough to figure it out, then you'll get in. And if you're big enough to knock it down, of course you're going to get in. Alright, that's it for this video, which, ironically enough, was shorter than I thought, considering there was more questions for it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Leave a like, comment, subscribe. Leave your questions down in the comment section down below. Hit the notifications bell down by the subscribe button. Share this video with your friends. And until next time, take care. Aloha.